We finally go hands-on the Samsung Ative S. Google counts down 2013 with daily deals, and Nokia wasn't really serious about Windows Phone 7.8. I'm Jaime Rivera, seriously wondering why Samsung didn't come up with a Windows Phone camera as well? And this is Pocket Now Daily. Yes, believe it or not, it's finally here. Our review unit for the Samsung Ative S has finally arrived. This device is only a little more mysterious than Apple's white iPhone 4 that took 10 months to leave the oven. The device has finally landed at Michael Fisher's office for full review treatment. He already started his unboxing, but don't let me bore you with specifics. Make sure you watch the links down below for full details on his coverage. There's a lot to talk about with this phone. Some things are good, some things are not so good, so make sure you watch. Now, speaking of Samsung, they just released a new device that we're not sure if we should celebrate about. It's called the Galaxy Grand, and even though it looks a lot like the Galaxy S3, well, it's not. This device sports a 5-inch display, which is great, but it sports a painful WVGA resolution. I'm trying to remember what year this is, but aside from that, it also has a dual-core processor, and even though it runs Jelly Bean, we're not sure if this is going to be a really good device or not. Kind of hard to see why Samsung is using these great designs like the Galaxy S3 and throwing them away with a monster spec like this one, but we'll probably see the device at CES 2013, so we'll keep you posted. Now, speaking of HTC, we've got good and bad news. On the bad side, apparently the HTC Butterfly will not be a European device, meaning we won't get a carrier unlocked international variant, and it'll be a US and Asia exclusive. Now, on the good side, apparently we will be getting that HTC M7 device sporting a 4.7-inch display with the same 1080p resolution that we've got on the Butterfly, for those that found that the 5-inch display on the Butterfly was awkward. We'll most likely see this M7B launch at MWC 2013, and there are some monster specs on this device, so stay tuned. Now, on the other hand, Google is a bearer of good news for the holidays, as apparently they are counting down until January 1st, 2013 to offer daily deals just like they did last year. Last year, they offered significant discounts in applications, and this time they have one daily deal. And even though this deal for today probably is not the best deal ever, you could probably just wait till tomorrow and see what they're offering. This deal, of course, counts down until January 1st, 2013, so just visit the Google Play Store every day. You could be surprised. And finally, for the oh no, what are you doing news of the day, Nokia had us all on the edge of our seats looking for our Lumia 800 devices, because apparently they were launching Windows Phone 7.8 for the device. All of us here at Pocket Now were scrambling trying to find our review unit, and as it turns out, yesterday they broke our hearts by saying that no, they'll be launching it until early 2013, which could be 6 months in Microsoft days, if you know what that means. I'm just curious, I mean, that leads me to the question of the day. How many of you are actually still using legacy Windows Phone devices? I've got two in a drawer and I'm not looking back. Leave us a comment down below. And if you want an earlier scoop of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tablet world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow. It has the same form factor and design, but this guy... Bam. Now, speaking of Samsung, they've just... Deja de reírte, no.
Yo estoy viendo la tarde.